Sí, baba.
What's going on, boys and girls? Man, it's Nature Joe here again today, sitting in for Brother Jordan. He's out again. He's doing his thing. But man, Nature Joe's going to take over. We're going to talk about two things today. Y'all ready for it? Number one, God gold. Number two, nature, baby. That's what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about how them things stick together like peanut butter and jelly. Man, they correlate like something I ain't never seen before. I tell you what. We're going to dig into it today. We're going to have a real big time. I hope y'all are plumb excited like I am. Man, there's a couple things in life, like I just mentioned, that gets me fired up. And that's nature and God gold. And today, we're going to talk about why they call me Nature Joe. And I'm going to give y'all some God gold that you can put in your pocket and take with you on the road. So they call me Nature Joe. I had a fella ask me that one day, Nature Joe, why they call you Nature Joe? And I was like, man, it's because I love nature so much. He said, why you love nature so much, Nature Joe? Man, this fella was full of questions, I tell you what. And I said, man, I love nature because it's cool as all get out. I mean, have you been outside? Have you seen all them things out there like the frogs at the pond? Man, them trees, them animals, all these cool things out there in nature. You get out there, man, nature gets me more jacked up than a Mississippi jackrabbit, man. I tell you what. But number two, even bigger than that, is that's where I get to see God. And that fella said, what are you talking about? I said, man, I see God every day out there. He said, what? Man, you can't see God. Can't nobody see God. I was like, well, let me show you a little something that somebody showed me back in the day, opened up my eyes to see God. Now, I'll let you see God too, man. It's in Romans 1:20. It says, for his invisible attributes, namely his eternal power and divine nature, that's all the qualities of God, have been clearly perceived. That means they've been clearly seen. Ever since the creation of the world and the things that have been made, which is everything outside in nature, and the things that have been made, so they are without excuse. And you know, I used to think that way back in the day too, man. Like, you can't see God, can't nobody see God. But then I got to going outside in nature. My wardrobe changed a little bit. I started wearing nature. And more nature. But when I started going out there, I started realizing this verse was real deal, man. Like it's saying all these invisible qualities. And what really made sense to me was thinking about somebody one time told me, man, it's like the wind. You can't see the wind, but you can feel the wind. And you can see the impact the wind has on the trees when it blows through and them limbs start to shake. Well, God's the same way, man. You can't see God, but you can feel God as he's working in your life, and you can see and feel the impact that he has every single day in your life. And when you walk outside and see his creation that he created with his own hands, you see the character, all the qualities of God, and all the work that he's done. So when you see that stuff, man, it changes a lot. So for anyone who says, man, you can't see God, you can't know God, man, we are without excuse, man. We ain't make no excuses. We can't be no whiners and complainers. Man, we got no excuses. We walk outside, we see his creation. Man, that is just like seeing God. And that's what gets me so fired up about nature. So for today, I want you guys to just take a step back from your lives, whatever you got going on, whatever you're doing. And I want you to walk outside, man. I want you to take a look at all that nature around you. And I want you to take it in. Take some deep breaths and just take it in. And just look at every tree. Look at every animal you see. Even look at the people you see passing you as you go along in your day. And know that God created every single bit of that. Like, God's hand was at work in all of that. So when you step back and see God like that, woo! It changes everything about how you see yourself and your life with God. Because even in them moments you feel like God ain't working, man, He is always working. He's always up to something. That's God for you right there, man. That's what God does. That's who God is. Now get outside some of that creation today, man. Take a step back and just look at how cool God is and all the work He does in our lives. Now y'all have a good day. Nature Joe out, baby. Get wild.
Glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's land.